In northwest France, in the heart of the Brittany region, is Rennes. Unlike a lot of other major cities in the country, this one is a bit under the radar for most non-French people. But the city has a hidden gem. Not just one, but two metro lines. Here's the catch. The city's total population is just 227,000, making it one of the smallest cities in the world with a mass transit system. In 2022, Rennes inaugurated the second line of their metro system. It's roughly 9 miles long and cuts through the city in a diagonal axis. That might not sound impressive at first until you realize what it means. This isn't a megacity like Paris or London. Rennes is smaller than Pittsburgh, yet it's running a sleek, driverless metro system. This second line connects key neighborhoods, universities, hospitals, and the city center, interconnecting the city and giving residents more mobility options. And thanks to its fully automated system, the metro runs frequently, efficiently, and with minimal downtime. So the question is, how did a relatively small French city pull off something cities 10 times its size still struggle with? To understand that, we have to rewind a bit. Back to when Rennes made a bold choice that would shape its future. This is an aerial view of Rennes in the 1950s. The population of the city then was just around 150,000. It had a tram system with a number of lines connecting the entire city. Like most European cities in the post-war era, there was a push towards growth in the periphery. And like most cities around the world, its tram system was dismantled and out of use by the 70s. But by the 80s, traffic and mobility had become such big issues that voters and politicians wanted to find a solution. Even though the metropolitan area had grown and cities in the periphery were much larger than before, Rennes' municipal area remained compact and dense. This is much different than what had occurred in North America, where suburban sprawl was matched with a diminishing urban density. Because Rennes remained compact, the push for a metro system was not far-fetched. But just because the idea made sense on paper didn't mean it could survive in the real world. In fact, what came next would push Rennes' metro dreams to the brink, and almost kill the project before it ever broke ground. The most expensive per capita metro system in the world. That's what Bernard Bassan, Minister of Transport, said in 1993 about the Rennes Metro project. As minister, he cut the state's expected funding of the project by 30%. The opposition to this project was fierce. Local groups were worried that certain elevated sections would be an eyesore. Green politicians pushed for a tramway and center-right politicians denounced the cost. After 10 years of planning and a congestion situation that was getting worse, the little city's big metro plan seemed to be on its deathbed. But against these odds, the city's long-term mayor did not concede. Edmond Hervé, first elected in 1977 at just 35 years old, was convinced that a metro would be the best solution, and the automated VAL system the best technology. With political opposition to the project mounting and an unrelated national scandal unfolding against the mayor, he staked the Line A's construction on an upcoming municipal election. As it turned out, in 1995, Edmond Hervé, running on a platform of getting the metro done, won a resounding victory with nearly 60% of the vote in his favor. By 2002, construction had finished after 5 years of work, and Rennes was officially the smallest city in the world with a metro system. Line A was 9.5 kilometers long, following a roughly diagonal path from the southeast of the city to the northwest. But was this project a success? When Line A first opened, the results spoke for themselves. In its very first year, the Rennes Metro was carrying between 70,000 and 85,000 riders every single day, easily surpassing expectations. It didn't just offer a new way to move around the city, it replaced an old one. Estimates show that roughly 30,000 daily car trips were cut and converted to public transit use. And the growth didn't stop. By 2012, just 10 years after inauguration, yearly ridership had climbed from 20 million to 28 million. And by 2019, it had reached 38 million. To keep up with the demand, the system had to evolve too. Train frequencies increased from every 2.5 minutes to just 1.5 minutes at peak hours, an interval that even some major metro systems struggle to match. The success of Line A made a second line inevitable. In 2022, Line B officially opened, and by 2023, it had already seen over 21 million rides. But the story wasn't without its setbacks. In early 2024, just as the system was hitting its stride, a series of technical failures forced Line B to close for months, from January to July. It was a major blow, especially for a city that had built its reputation on the reliability of its network. Rennes' metro system isn't perfect. But in a world where much bigger cities still struggle to deliver reliable transit, Rennes shows what can happen when you think long term and actually follow through. They didn't wait until they became a big city to invest in public transport. They built a future they wanted first. Which leaves one final question. If a city of just 227,000 people can pull this off, what's stopping everyone else?